Hello, Libra, and welcome to your month ahead reading for July. If this is your first time here, my name is Laura. I'm from babycurltarot.com. I am a root worker, tarot reader, and oracle reader. So again, this is going to be a general collective reading for all of my Libras for the month of July. Since this is a general reading, please keep in mind that not all messages will resonate for every single Libra watching this video. If that happens to be the case, I do offer personal one-on-one readings and I do offer a month ahead spread, and you can find the information for my website where you can connect with me and schedule a personal reading down below in the description box. All right, so let's go ahead and jump right into the reading. I'm going to start off with the Legendary Ladies Goddess deck for some general energy, things you may be experiencing during this month. Spirit, what messages do you have for my Libras for the month of July? Spirit, what messages do you have for my Libras for the month of July? Oops. Spirit, what messages do you have for my Libras for the month of July? Oh, okay. Took a little bit, but there we go. All right, Libras, we got Amaterasu, the goddess of inner beauty. And we also got the goddess Ran, or Ran. I don't know how to pronounce it properly, so don't come for me in the comments, but Ran or Ran, the goddess of focus. Okay, a lot of focus on the inner world here already, my Libras. This is probably going to be... I don't want to say an inner makeover, but maybe it is. Maybe it's a little bit of a revamping. But let's see. Let's get into your tarot cards. Spirit, what messages do you have for my Libras for the month of July? What messages do you have for my Libras for the month of July? Oop. Okay, we've got two. Okay, starting off with two kings. It's amazing. We have the King of Wands, King of Pentacles. Okay, Libras. This is a really great spread so far. Let's take a look at what we have. Libras, we have the King of Wands. Okay, we also have the King of Pentacles. We have the Nine of Pentacles, the Four of Wands, and the Three of Pentacles. And of course, at the bottom of the deck, we have the Ace of Swords. Wow. There's a lot going on here. Give me 1 second, Libras. Let me see if I can get a clear picture of a story here. A lot of wands and pentacles, energy, earth and fire. Okay, a lot of material things, work, career, money, stability, health. Okay, a lot of really great cards. Two kings is really interesting. You may be under the guidance of two very distinct individuals. One may be a financial advisor or a career advisor. Okay. One may be a boss. I also heard spiritual. And I don't always associate the King of Wands with a spiritual leader, but this is a visionary, the King of Wands. So I can also, personally, I associate visionaries with also, obviously, within the term visionary, there's vision. So a spiritual guide or a spiritual mentor. Very interesting. These can be aspects of two people. This could be aspects of one person within the same body. Someone who is not only a spiritual leader, but someone who is extremely rooted in reality and material things as well. And they've done extremely well for themselves. So, however they're guiding you, I think they're trying to set you up for really great success this month and in months to come, honestly. With a lot of pentacles being here, this is stability. This isn't just short-term success or small wins we see sometimes in the workplace, but this is long-term growth and stability. In particular, with this nine of coins, this is someone who is, oh wait, this is someone who is really, really growing their wealth and doing so independently. You may be an entrepreneur, Libras, some of you, and that's why you have not only spiritual but financial guidance here, stability guidance. Okay. People may be showing you where to invest right now. Some of you may be investing in different forms of maybe markets, different types of markets, whether it's bitcoins or stocks and bonds. Maybe it's investing in, I don't know. I don't know what else you can invest in out there, but maybe property for some of you. Okay. But I see a lot of investment, not only within the material, but within the spiritual, emotional, and physical, within yourself, putting a lot of investment into yourself, making sure that you are taken care of, that you are feeling and looking your best. But from the foods you eat to the books and media you consume to the way you take care of your hair, your clothes, I mean, really making sure that you, again, are feeling and looking your best. Wow. We also have elements of the home. So, like I said, some of you may be investing in property. Some of you may be getting married or finding someone, a spiritual counterpart for you to be in a relationship with. Some of you may be attracting them this month. And as a result of you taking care of yourself, that's definitely a result. People are going to be attracted to you when you take care of yourself, Libras. Not that you guys don't. Libras are typically known to be very well kept, put together, stylish people. So I don't see that being a major problem for you, but you may be just kicking it up a notch this month, okay? And as a result, you may have like this glow about you, and that's where you're attracting some potential suitors, counterparts here. And it does feel like you will find somebody for some of you. If that's your focus, some of you may very well find an extremely suitable match. Okay, someone you definitely feel at home with, comfortable with, vibe with on a really, really beautiful level. I love to see it. There's so many great things here, Libras. I don't see one negative thing at all, honestly. I don't see a single negative thing. Three of Pentacles here. Things in the work sector may be kicking up. Okay. You may be reaping the rewards, okay, from your career at this point in time. Some of you may be receiving bonuses or some sort of recognition or compensation for work that you've performed, and you're now taking that maybe extra bit of cash and investing it into something that can grow and multiply over time, okay? Using that money wisely. It's beautiful. This is amazing. This is a really beautiful re reading, Libras. This Ace of Swords is also interesting to me. This could be coming in as a sort of message, epiphany, dream, If you guys are intuitive, maybe it's a message from, again, if you work with someone spiritual, you could be receiving a message. Maybe it's this video that's going to spark something in you, but there's a definite message or communication that kind of sparks all of this. Very interesting. There may be an idea or a plan of action that is discussed, or you have, again, an idea that just comes to you in the middle of the night at one night, and you start working with these two to kind of get you on the path of what it is you are trying to achieve this month, which is beautiful. I love this. Okay. Libras, if you would like to do a personal one-on-one reading to really dive into what this is about, if this is resonating for you, you can contact me in at my website to get a personal reading, and I also offer root work services so that you can take advantage of this particular energy. We can almost enhance it. Okay, so if that's something you're interested in, definitely reach out and check out my website down below in the description box. But let's go ahead and get into some more oracle cards here, starting with the Wisdom of the Oracle. Spirit, what additional messages do you have for my Libras for the month of July? What additional messages do you have for my Libras for the month of July? Any additional messages for my Libras for the month of July? Happy, happy. This is a great month for you, Libras. I feel like you are in a really good space mentally, spiritually. What's funny is this woman has a star on her forehead. I don't know if you can see it, but that's right where the third eye is located. And yeah, it just feels like that third eye is completely opened. You are experiencing some major beautiful shifts here within, for sure. Not extreme happiness, but very, very large amounts of happiness, success, growth. Amazing. This is an amazing reading. You also got deep knowing at the bottom of the deck. And again, that ties into this Ace of Swords for me. There's like this epiphany or an aha moment that may be coming to you where you're like, I understand what I need to do now. And I do believe you're going to be either coming into contact with people, or maybe you already have people around you that can help you get to what it is that you have been thinking or dreaming of. All right, Libras, let me go ahead and get into these tea leaves and see if there are any additional messages for your month of July. Okay, Spirit, we got some jumpers here. All right, let me find this other one. Oof. Let's see. Okay, we got lightning. Ooh, control your anger or you will be sorry. Ooh, okay, be careful of this, Libras. Particularly with this King of Wands energy. I don't do reversals in this deck, but the King of Wands, when he comes up in reverse, can be a very angry hothead. Okay, so even though he isn't in the reverse, he is here and that potential is there. So that fiery attitude can sometimes backfire if we're not careful. So just keep that in mind. We got grapes. Time to go out and have fun. Which is funny because I always associate the Nine of Pentacles with like a vineyard. This woman has this sprawling farm and vineyard, and yeah, her success comes from growing those grapes. We have the coins. Money will be coming to you. Yes. Claim that. Leave a like, leave a comment. Claim that, Libras. Okay. Money will be coming to you. Yes. Come through. We have the grasshopper. Situations in the balance that require careful handling. Okay. So it does feel like there is possibly an opportunity for you to really pounce on what it is that you are sparking here this month. Like I said, I do offer root work services to help you guys maximize the energy going on. So if you would like to talk to me about that and what we can do to really make sure that this energy not only sticks around but is maximized as much as possible, go ahead and reach out to me via my website. We also have the diamond. You'll be receiving or giving a precious gift. I love that. I kind of get that with the Four of Wands and the Ace of Swords. Okay, I see these two women holding hands, exchanging energy, love, words of kindness, care, and affirmation. But let's see here. Any additional messages for my Libras for the month of July? Okay. We have target, a goal-oriented person. Absolutely. Especially with this Ace of Swords. It's like you have an idea and you are not going to let go of it until you achieve it. And honestly, with the Nine of Pentacles and the Three of Pentacles, you're someone who works really hard and is diligent in creating what it is you want to see manifest in your life, my Libras. So definitely right on point with that card. Fire, strong emotion, passionate love, or hate. Interesting. Okay, this fire for me can be coming through in terms of a match, like I had discussed earlier, a possible love interest or suitor. So keep that in mind for the month of July. My Libras, that is all I am seeing for you. Leave a like, leave a comment if this resonated for you. Let me know how it resonated for you. Also subscribe and subscribe. Sorry guys, I'm still new to YouTube. So I'm figuring out what it is that I need to say here, but go ahead and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this one. I do monthly and weekly readings for all the signs, as well as occasional pick a card readings. If you would also like to follow me on my other socials or reach out to me and schedule a personal reading, all of that information is below in the description box. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.